It'll be interesting to see what he has to offer in tonight's main event. Tail of the Tape is brought to you by Toyo Tires, official tire of UFC. Jared Cannonier, ranked number 3, 7 years older than the 7th ranked Sean Strickland. Strickland is 2 inches taller, standing 6 feet 1 inches tall. Cannonier has an inch and a half edge in reach. It's a near coin flip betting-wise. Cannonier a small favorite at minus 120 right now. Setting the table for our final fight of the year, Joe Martinez.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Live from the UFC Apex, Las Vegas, Nevada, USA. This is the main event of the evening. 5 rounds scheduled this in the UFC middleweight division. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, the executive director is Jeff Mullen with chairman Stephen J. Klubeck. The 3 judges scoring at octagon side, Derek Cleary, Sal D'Amato, and Junichiro Kamijo. And when the action begins inside the octagon, your referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready and the fighters are ready. Las Vegas, make some noise if you are ready! Introducing you first, fighting out of the blue corner, this mixed martial artist stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at the limit 186 pounds in 29 fights. His record stands at 25 victories with 4 defeats. He is the UFC's number 7 ranked middleweight contender in the world from Corona, California. Here is Sean Strickland! And across the octagon, his opponent fighting out of the red corner. A striker, wrestler standing 5 feet 11 inches tall. He weighed in officially 185 and one half pounds, and in 21 fights, holds a record of 15 victories with 6 defeats. Fighting out of Glendale, Arizona, here is the UFC's number 3 ranked middleweight contender in the world, Jared the Killer Gorilla Cannonier!
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. Let's keep it clean. Touch gloves, let's do it.
A simple fist bump from Sean Strickland to Jared Cannonier, and you can just kind of see the nervous energy between these two as they get ready for 5 rounds, if needed, in a high-stakes main event.
Ready, let's fight.
Near coin flip. Odds-wise, this fight clock is brought to you by Toyo Tires, official tire of UFC. Strickland in blue, Cannonier in black. Strickland, native of Southern California, but it's been his partnership with Eric Nixick in his corner and the team at Extreme Couture that's really channeled his talent and his abilities into becoming a top-ranked contender in this division. And for Jared Cannonier, a move to the Phoenix area back in 2017. Former member of the U.S. Army, then worked at the FAA for a while before he found mixed martial arts and chased being a pro fighter at the top level. That's what brought him to the MMA lab.
Strickland is one of those guys, he has a knack for being able to stay in the pocket, being right there in range to strike, but just slides out of the way of some of these big shots that come his way. But Cannonier is not over-rushing into those shots. If he doesn't see it's there, he's taking his time, looking at the legs. These guys know they have 5 rounds to work with. They're going to be tactical here.
Watch Strickland train a lot, and he spars more than anything. And he spars with little gloves like this. And he doesn't use a lot of big glove sparring, so that's why he's so good at sliding, just staying in the pocket. He's so used to that feeling.
Right.
Whereas a lot of us, we switch from 16-ounce gloves or 14-ounce gloves to small gloves. He pretty much always trains with little gloves. So I don't know if that's why he's so mean, but could be part of it.
Stakes are high when you're training with 4 ounces on.
all the time.
And he'll flat out tell you that. He says, I don't train. Like, he doesn't treat himself like a professional athlete much in the way that others do. He just says, I go and fight at the gym to get ready for my fights in the octagon.
And I've seen it, and it creates a different style. Like Felder was saying, he stays in the pocket different. The way he uses the jab, as fighters, we can see it. I mean, it's fun to watch because it's always threatening a knockout.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't know what's going to happen.
Halfway through the first of five rounds, Cannonier telling us this week, if he looks back and is honest with himself and his past performances, he acknowledges the low punch count and the fact that he wants to increase his activity. Pretty clear when he watches the film. We'll see if he turns up the volume here.
Well, I think it's a little unfair for him to say that against a guy like Adesanya, who,
right,
if you try to overthrow on him, it's over for you. But nice timing on that takedown for Strickland. This is where he said, if I'm smart, I'm going to wrestle this guy. And, you know, I think it's a matter of mixing his wrestling, yes, and his striking, not just one. And right now you're seeing him do that. And this is where Strickland's the best, when he's thinking and jabbing.
Get your legs involved now. Backside trip.
Nice picking his shots here too. Not getting the takedown right away, but at least making sure he's scoring points while he's in that clinch position with Cannonier.
That's we've talked about it all night. You want to take away a good jab, that's how you do it. Eat up that lead leg and then start countering the jab. And that's what Strickland does so well, is he uses that jab. So if you take away the jab, then how does he set up his offense? And that's what we're seeing Cannonier try to do for himself. Take away the offense. That jab is everything for Strickland.
Nice leg kicks here from Cannonier.
Cannonier switching stances, looking for an opening. Nice right cross from Strickland on the 1-2. 15 seconds left in the first. One in the book, second round coming up.
Take a deep breath and just relax for a minute. Thank you, Coach. Here's the lid. Randy?
You start pressing him, landing a jab, and Yachty starts opening
up. Dog, you got this, yeah. Dog. Hey, you got the time.
Let's go.
Hey, Sean, come here. Hey, when we talk about him,
Yes, sir. Hey, when you wrestle, get your legs involved into your trips. Take them right down and sit down on them. Let's go. Come on.
Back and ready for round number two in the final bout of 2022 in the octagon. I would ask you what you noticed in the Sean Strickland corner, but they don't need to tell him much.
No, they keep it pretty simple, but
get down the middle and check.
Me and Dom noticed just it's incredible how calm. And I mean, you don't even see Strickland really open his mouth to breathe in these fights. It's pretty awesome to see how he just keeps himself so relaxed in there, especially with somebody like Cannonier in front of you who's chopping at your legs and looking for these big power shots.
Yeah, I just noticed when you watch Cannonier, there's a lot of explosion in that first round, exploding into punches, exploding into range. Whereas when you watch Strickland, there's no explosion whatsoever. It's just throw the jab out, forward pressure, just slide out of the way, baby movements, and it's a very economical style for five rounds that Strickland is fighting right now. Very patient. See, that jab's really starting to touch now. And when he starts touching that jab over five rounds, I mean, how many jabs are you going to land in five rounds? What, 60, 100? That adds up.
Yeah, a lot. And the footwork of Strickland, I feel, gets unmentioned a little bit sometimes, too, how he circles off just so slightly. You saw how he regained the center of the octagon there a second ago with not much movement at all.
Well said. Yeah, he slides out of the way. He doesn't move in straight lines.
And he punches as he does it. Look, he's moving his feet as he's throwing that jab.
Exactly. And that's what all our coaches on pads tell us to do. Move your feet first. Don't
just
throw with
don't.
Your hands. He's doing it well. You're right. That's a great read. Fundamentals are key. And that's what you're seeing out of Strickland right now. Cannonier's looking good. He's switching stance more. He's got power. He is letting his offense go the way he wants.
Dean Thomas, what do you see?
You know, to add on to what Strickland does that's so tricky and awkward is he uses his height well, and he backs up, and when Cannonier comes in, he just kind of sticks his arms out there. So when Cannonier punches, his punches actually punch Strickland in the arms. And that is not typical defense, but it works for him.
Ooh. Cannonier coming closer.
Close with that right hook. But I do like that that Cannonier is using the leg kicks. I think if he's having trouble getting in there and landing these power punches, but these leg kicks are heavy. There you go. Keep chipping away. Strickland's got his jab. You establish your leg kicks from that distance. So this way you're both offensive from out here.
That is now 13 leg kicks landed through the first round and a half for Jared Cannonier. I did notice the slightest of limps on his way back to his corner for Sean Strickland. Cannonier looking for a home for a power punch.
He wants to time the low kick, obviously, of Strickland's jab. That's what he's looking for. I think that Strickland's waiting to really turn up his offense until after round three, or in the middle of round three. I think he's just being smart, fighting very economical, and just keeping conserving until he can start unloading combinations from here.
Just out of range as Cannonier, as Strickland backs off.
So he's starting to frustrate Cannonier, and that's why Cannonier is asking him to sit still, because like you said, Felder, he's just out of the way with every one of those big shots, just barely off, slides off to the side one way or the other, very clean. See, like that, just slides out.
Yeah, it's so frustrating, because it doesn't seem like he's
far
away.
But
he's right there, I got to hit him, and you're missing.
And that's from all those rounds with these gloves, with these 4-ounce gloves. So he's noticed he's never loading. He's never overextending Strickland. He's just touching. Just touching.
Because he's used to fighting in the format that you'd be actually fighting with, where you got knee pads, elbow pads, shin pads.
Oh, Strickland opens up here a little bit.
Ooh, big pass there. Now he's starting to throw some power.
He waits till the opening's there to really take the risks.
Final seconds of round two.
Good eye, good adjustment.
Oh, big right from Cannonier, right at the horn. We'll keep it here between rounds. Back and forth they go.
That's the second time you threw that up kick. Yeah, I just kind of watched that.
Adjustment on that. Okay, let's
just breathe for a second. We're two rounds through, okay? Going into round three right now.
He's gonna start to pick it up a little bit.
Yeah, don't rush that lead, but he's hurting on it.
Final for the jab.
All right, let's take a look at some of the jabs here from Sean Strickland, and used that here to catch the kick, and ultimately I think ended up on top for a second there, but they scrambled on the fence. But you see Jared Cannonier, from distance, has really had most success with these heavy leg kicks. Here's a big punch. Cracks the chin there of Sean Strickland, but the jab and the movement for Sean and second leg shot. Kicks and power shots for Cannonier.
Tuesdays, catch up on all the latest MMA talk with DC and RC. Our guy Daniel Cormier trades bars with Super Bowl champ Ryan Clark. You can find the show on YouTube, ESPN Plus, and now on ESPN2 at midnight Eastern. Third round as we get deeper into our middleweight main event. Very close fight. One takedown for Sean Strickland. It came in the first round. Total strikes, 34 for Strickland, 32 for Cannonier. It is anybody's fight at the moment. Oh, and Strickland, did he buckle him with that jab? Cannonier back to the leg kick.
Yeah, my love just looking down at what people commenting on Twitter are saying. It's some people have Cannonier, 1-1. It's close.
Well, you're seeing Strickland land that jab more and more this round. One of the ways he's sneaky with is you'll see him slide to southpaw just for a second right there. You'll see his feet switch and he'll go right jab instead of a left jab. And it's just, you can't tell he switched to a southpaw stance and he's just still firing jabs, but it looks like a right hand. So it's just a little longer reach than you think. These little switches that he does in Strickland, you can't really see his feet switch when he throws that southpaw jab.
Yeah, he does a very good job of using his punches in sequence with his footwork, which is difficult to do.
Cannonier is just really, like that. The Cannonier exactly. Really setting up that big shot. I mean, this whole fight, all you see Cannonier doing is like, I'm gonna land. Just waiting, taking his time for that haymaker to land. That's kind of how you gotta fight Strickland.
They both land a jab in that exchange. Strickland's pumping it out. More volume coming from Strickland in this round three.
You see Cannonier putting his shell up, guarding high now, just knowing I think he's got to commit to getting through some of these jabs and maybe eat a couple on the arm so that he can throw his big power shots. Is that sneaky jab, switch, jab there from Strickland.
And then every now and then he'll slide those teep kicks into the gut. Those hurt more than they look like.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Big lands from both.
There it is.
Heaviest combination of the fight from Cannonier comes with just over 2 minutes to go in round three.
He takes that wear and tear before you start landing these shots, but that's the best combo for Cannonier right there. That left hook, right hand, I think that's the moneymaker if you're going to land on Strickland.
He's being much more aggressive here in the third.
Good. Looking for the lead left hook.
You got it.
Nice. Strickland starts to open up. And again, just out of range from the power shots.
Cannonier, that southpaw left high is there all day. We'll see if he sees it. Because he's switching stance a lot, but Cannonier doesn't really use that left high kick too much. He's usually landing his hands.
Good check there from Strickland. Heavy leg kick check.
You see each of these guys striking defense, proving to be elusive. Cannonier looking to pin him along the fence.
He's going to always throw back.
Very inside.
Open him up. Thanks.
40 seconds,
Jake. Good body shot.
Good body.
All right, right up the midline.
35.
That's right there, you do. Fuck him, all right?
30 seconds, shoot on tight.
That's it, that's it. Get on it, Jake. You're right back on that volume, Jake.
20 seconds until we reach round four. A little more volume from each fighter, but again, not definitive one way or the other. Oh, big left hook from Cannonier, who started to land some power shots. Maybe that was the biggest difference. Main event rounds upcoming.
Much better round. Much better round. Hey, listen, that's a great swing round there. I need a right teep up the fucking midline. Right fucking teep up the midline. Number two, listen to me. He's kind of come over top of our jab with our overhand. Throw the jab, pull counter, and react.
Yes, sir. Two more rounds.
Let's go. Two more rounds. Hey, more pick rounds. The fucking volume up.
Let's go. You're
Let's
right.
go.
I'm with you.
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, and the Yabby's there off of the jab. Just don't throw it out in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. He's made a good adjustment on that, so now we need to counter adjust.
Okay.
He's reacting to all those leg kicks. You're waiting too long to counter.
Yeah.
You're slipping, slipping, slipping. You got to slip in, and then you can go to the body or to the legs. I don't care. But let's answer him somehow, not let him work for free for 10 seconds.
Stay on your jab to the body. Stay on the face.
Okay, that's three excellent rounds. Let's go. Two more.
Two more, baby.
Coming up next, don't miss a recap of all the action on the UFC Fight Night post-show on ESPN. Plus, our panel of experts break down the entire card. Charlie Arnold interviews the big winners. It is only right here on E+.
Fight.
Round four. Between Cannonier and Strickland, you heard the corner advice from each.
I mean, it's a close fight. Both guys are doing things so well, but these rounds, you know, what's setting you apart?
Right.
What's swaying the judges?
Yeah, they're strike for strike. I land, you land. I land, you land.
The unofficial numbers are almost literally strike for strike.
And no takedown attempts, really. Maybe one from Strickland early on.
It got to the ground once in the first round, but he certainly hasn't chased it. You heard Eric Nixick tell Sean Strickland he wants more kicks up the middle.
And more combinations. And we just saw a three-piece combo instead of just a jab on both sides. He's adding combos now and leading into it in the fourth and fifth rounds. Nice another, check on that one.
Another
that
one, hurt. Yeah. Another one checked.
Stay on it. Keep the middle off. Keep the middle off. Good shot. Right on your hands. Perfect.
Stay outside that range. All right. Fakes, legs, and cuts. See, let's keep going. I'm telling you, Sean. Right to the guard. His head is coming right down the center. Right now. Right there. Nice, Sean.
Ooh. That would have hurt him a little. Tagged him. He tagged Cannonier with that right hand.
That definitely slowed him down for just a second there where he stood still.
More volume here. We're on him now. Give me up that midline. Focus. Run over. Footwork. Back over there. I need your face back. Let's go.
There you go. Oh. Nice one, too. Sean's starting to really feel it here and turning it up in round four, which we talked about would probably be about when he would turn it up. You said it, Dom. After round three, maybe midway through round three. Oh, but there's another solid leg kick there from Cannonier. Just has not been able to connect with that power yet.
Right. And looking for a way in, looking to feint his way in to land a big shot. You heard John Crouch tell Cannonier that they wanted to follow up quicker, whether it's a counter or off the leg kick.
The most success for Cannonier, that left kick is the one that I see will be the most success for him from the southpaw stance. That left kick, and then when he's conventional, the left hook, right hand have been the best combos. And as we saw versus Strickland in his fight against Pajeda, that was what hurt him, was a left hook. You've got to attack that left side. excuse me, that right side of Strickland. He's so good with that jab hand.
See the striking numbers at all three levels, mostly body and leg work in terms of the discrepancy for Cannonier. Strickland almost primarily headshots. And not much to speak of in the way of kicks for Strickland.
No, just little front kicks up the middle, which Nixick is calling for. He wants more of them. And that body kick not too long ago that Strickland landed was pretty solid. When he lets him go, he's got the ability to use it. He just loves to sit back in the pocket, stay just out of range and use his jab. But he's been opening up much more here in round four, throwing right hands more, combinations.
Well, if you pay attention to Strickland's style too, it's a MMA glove striking style, because if you try to fight the way Strickland does with 16-ounce gloves, all your straight punches and all your teep kicks up the middle would be blocked with big gloves. But with 4-ounce gloves, they slip through, and that's why I always punch just straight. But right now, Cannonier is touching him.
Yeah, a couple of right hands getting through. Cannonier's getting closer.
Cannonier attack mode there. Strickland tries to tie him up. They're slippery at this point of the fight. Final minute of the fourth. And Strickland perhaps looking to cage him in and launch another power combination. Oh. There it is, Dom, that hook.
Whoa.
Now a big left.
Getting aggressive. Sean smiles it off, though. But Jarrett's going for it.
It kind of reminds me of the Drew Dober, Bobby Green. You got to kind of eat a couple of Stricklands, get in the pocket, and then let the haymakers go, and maybe you'll land. But that's what you saw Dober has to do, and I think you might have to see Cannonier do that in the fifth.
Our final fight of the year heads to the final round of the year. Fifth coming up.
5 minutes. Listen to me. I need you to throw the fucking right teep up the midline. I'm telling you, it's fucking there. Look at me. Left high kicks, right fucking teeps. When he goes southpaw, blast that fucking kick, man. Hey, I don't know what the fucking score is here. You got to go, man. You got to add that volume on and make this a fucking dogfight.
Yes, sir.
You got me? Hey, let's go get this motherfucker. What do you got, coach?
Bro, this is your round. You need to make him move backwards. If you land 40 body punches this round, we win this fight. We'll go home with the win. You know what I mean? And then he's going to open up upstairs. We're going to knock his fucking ass out.
Gotcha.
You hear me?
Yeah.
Let's go. I want to see how much
Jay,
you want this round.
When you switch to southpaw, your right hook's money. It's
patience,
there. He has no answers.
Balance. Patience, balance, and ferocity. Let's fucking go.
You heard the instructions. John Crouch calling for a lot of volume to the body to open him up for the show-stopping finish. Meanwhile, Eric Nixick seems like he's having a tough time getting through. Fire the kick, fire the kick. It's tricky.
Yeah, well,
it's tricky.
Sean seems like the kind of guy that's going to do what Sean Strickland's going to do.
He is that kind of guy.
He's registering it, right? We see him acknowledging what Eric wants. It's tough as a fighter. You're in there. You know what's going on. You need that outside advice to help give you that perspective that you may not see. But sometimes you're just going to do what you feel is right in the moment.
Yeah, a little more power behind that combination from Strickland.
I mean, if I'm Strickland, I'm thinking, okay, which stance am I throwing that right teep kick? You want it from the conventional stance or the southpaw stance? Maybe it's hard for him to read when to throw it because Cannonier's constantly switching.
And there goes Cannonier to the body.
See, now your right teep isn't there when you go southpaw. The right teep's there when you... when you go conventional, the right to nice. Touched him there. Let's see if he can finish it out. Land the big combos.
Nice jab.
Double jab and follows it with a cross.
I think in the last 3 minutes of this fight, these guys really do got to sprint, though, and just lay it all on the line, because this could go either way.
It's still so even. And Sean is landing towards the end of the fight. And just as I say that, right hand gets through.
Big right hand. Yeah, you could see the right teep kick here when Cannonier southpaw. That'll work. I could see his coaches wanting to see that there. Nice. He lets the more than two go. He lands.
There's a nice 1-2 from Cannonier.
Things are starting to heat up here.
And you see Cannonier ate the jab and then to land two against Strickland. And that's what Strickland does so well. He'll hit you, and most people stop after they get hit by Strickland. Cannonier's going to have to eat it.
Oh. A power shot from Cannonier answered by a combination from Strickland. Just over 2 minutes to go.
Easier said than done.
Yeah, but I think you're right. I think he's got to intercept him. He's got to try to land his big power shots as he's getting touched or slipping just to the side of these jabs from Strickland.
Exactly the same way we saw Dober do it. It's pretty much you're kind of forced in that situation with a guy like Strickland, with a guy like Bobby Green.
Yeah, you're just not quite on the speed level to be able to handle jab for jab or you know, it's one thing to be like, oh, parry it. It's like, well, they're faster than you. What do you want me to do?
You got
to
eat it.
You got to eat it and come back.
With under 2 minutes to go, both are at 106 total strikes exactly.
A little bit of blood coming out of the nose now of Strickland.
Striking numbers by rounds. Cannonier holding the edge in round five.
So again, on this it comes down to damage. How do you judge the damage in this fight?
Tough to do. Tough in a fight like this. Judges are not privy to the numbers.
I mean, I guess you'd look at the nose of Strickland and say that counts, I guess.
Oh, yeah, right, sure. It's tight, man. This is a very tactical fight. Both guys have landed consistently in every round.
Final minute of fight action in 2022 from the Apex.
Last minute here. It's crazy. Strickland, though, to his credit, does always seem like he's still just in second gear.
Right.
It looks like he's in economy mode.
Right?
Yeah, just not using any fuel, all battery.
Tough
shot to the body. And they're still loading up. Now eating some counter shots from Strickland.
Yeah, both guys.
Right.
Back, tit for tat, back and forth, the whole fight.
One kick, we saw that kick out of Strickland.
And they're just gonna throw to the horn. Strickland now firing some kicks. And we go 25 minutes between top 10 middleweights. And now a show of respect. What a way to polish off 2022. 30-second break, the decision is all that's left.
Okay. Bro. Good. All good.
I rocked him like four or five times. I rocked him like five fucking times.
Welcome back. Here are the stats. Significant strikes. Strickland has the edge there. Head strikes, we showed you all fight. That was the trend. Strickland was going to the head. He doubles him up with 109. Body and leg belong to Cannonier.
You see here the big significant strikes right there. Counter left hook. Didn't really land too heavy, but it off balance Cannonier. And the right hand of Cannonier landed over and over off his left hook. Left hook, right hand. This right hand all night on Strickland was the main weapon, and that's why his nose got bloody. But the 1-2, that one that you just saw right there, that was Strickland's move all night. They were both landing right hands on each other heavily.
All that's left in the octagon for 2022 is the decision in our main event. For that, here's Joe Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Here are the totals. Judge Cleary scores at 49-46. For Cannonier, D'Amato, 49-46 for Strickland. And Camijo scores at 49-46 For your winner by split decision, Jared, the Killer Gorilla Cannonier!
I'm here with the winner, Jared Cannonier. Jared, congratulations. A very tight fight between both you guys.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.